Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Today's video is going to be a little bit different of a video. As you can tell, obviously Destiny is not here for this video. She didn't know if she wanted to be a part of this video or not be a part of the video. I said it was up to her. As you can tell, the title of this video is either living with ulcerative colitis or day in the life of living with ulcerative colitis in general. So basically, like I did say that I was gonna tell you guys that I was gonna do a new video, basically my disease, and tell you more in depth. And just, I really wanna raise awareness over this disease that I have, because not a lot of people know even what it is or how it affects the lives of, you know, millions of Americans. They say that 1 in 4 Americans actually have ulcerative colitis or Crohn's. So a lot of people have this disease. I'm gonna go over how my daily life is affected, what I have to eat every day, my diet to help keep it in remission. I might mention the medicine that I'm on, but I'll also go over like all the different medications I've had and gone through. It's just kind of the struggle of how it's affected me since when I was diagnosed when I was 15. So I've been living with this for, I'd say, about 5 years now. I think I'm coming up on my 6 year mark here in July. So I've been living with it for quite a while, and luckily I haven't had to have surgery. When it gets really bad to the point some people have to get part of their intestine removed, or if not all of their large intestine removed, and rectum, and be put on basically what's called a colostomy bag, which is essentially how you use the restroom. So basically, first thing I'm gonna go over is a little bit what ulcerative colitis even is to begin with. Ulcerative colitis is basically a disease in the large intestine, only in the large intestine. The disease itself, though, it's kind of like a subcategory of ulcerative colitis is. The actual disease is called inflammatory bowel disease. There's either two types that you can have. The first one being, people like to call it Crohn's disease, or, you know, just Crohn's. So you either have Crohn's or you have colitis. And Crohn's affects anywhere from the digestive tract from your mouth, you know, all the way down to, you know, your rectum. Whereas opposed to ulcerative colitis is just only in your large intestine and rectum. That's what it is. It's an ulcer. I have an ulcer in my large intestine. You have these when I'm having a bad day or my medicine, I'm not responding. It's called a flare up. And what happens with me when I'm not doing too good is I start to experience the symptoms. Essentially, what a person with ulcerative colitis does that they don't like to really talk about, but, you know, I'm open to talking about, and I don't have any shame when it comes to this disease, honestly, because it's a part of me and it's what I have to live with every day, so why be ashamed of it? You have to use the restroom upwards of, some people, like maybe 10-15 times a day when it gets really severe, and, you know, it takes over your whole large intestine, because it does start and it starts in smaller, like a smaller part or just a section of your large intestine. It doesn't start throughout the whole intestine and rectum. Some people have to use the restroom upwards of 20 to 30 times a day, some even more, from what I've seen online. My struggles with this disease growing up was mainly in high school, obviously being for the fact that I was first diagnosed and first started experiencing symptoms when I was at the age of 15. It was my sophomore year of high school. It literally started right at the beginning of second semester. It's kind of weird how that worked out, but that was just how it worked out. I started experiencing these symptoms. Basically, what I experienced is I have a fever. I got the chills really horribly, really bad. The thing is, though, you're not contagious when you're running a fever. It's just because your body trying to fight something off that isn't really, it's not gonna do any good by running a fever, essentially. It's under the category of an immunodisorder. My immune system is essentially attacking my large intestine, thinking it's bad, and that is what causes the inflammation, basically causes the symptoms. In high school, I started experiencing symptoms. I started having to go to the bathroom a lot, and it made it really hard for me in high school because I didn't really know who to talk to about it. It's not something you really wanna bring up to anyone. I didn't even tell anyone besides my girlfriend at the time, or my family, obviously, but anyone in my school besides my girlfriend was the only one who knew that I even had the disease. I didn't even tell my counselor or start telling my teachers about it until it was my senior year. So I really kept it under wraps for a long time, and I really don't know how I did it, because I was having to go to the bathroom urgently. And like, when you have to go, the only way I can explain it is like when you're having diarrhea, you know, when it hits, it hits. You can't hold it. You have to go right then and there, or you're gonna go in your pants. And, you know, whether you wanna laugh at that or not, it's the fact of the disease, and it's what we get to live with every single day, and it's not fun. I had to, you know, run out of the classroom really urgently a lot. A lot of teachers got mad at me, you know, and I didn't really understand, because I didn't even get diagnosed until after my second semester was up, until I had finished my sophomore year, and I essentially went to a gastro doctor and got a diagnosed. I had to get a scope and everything to even figure out what was going on and do a bunch of different tests until, you know, eventually my doctor, again, my gastro doctor, figured out that I had ulcerative colitis and diagnosed me with it. And then I found out that I had it. So at that point, I got put on medicine, which goes into the medicines. When you're under the age of 18, apparently with this disease, what they like to do is they like to do a step up approach. When you're an adult, you start with basically the strongest medicine, and then you kind of like work your way down if that doesn't work. When you're a kid, they like to start you out just because your body can't really, it's not good to start off with the strongest medicines because you're not fully developed and it's not good for you. These medicines are just not good for you, which is why with this disease, a lot of people like to do different things. They like to take herbal things. They like to take action, not take medicine at all. There are a lot of things I've seen online with like nicotine. People say nicotine works to help it calm it down. You know, I've seen coconut oil, doing a really strict diet. You know, I've seen all kinds of things, and you know, I've honestly tried them all. Unfortunately, the only thing I found that really works for me, I can't really attest it to one thing or attach to one thing, but I definitely, this medicine that I'm on now has really helped. Definitely my diet, a diet plays a big thing in helping me stay in remission. It doesn't really help you when you are having an active flare-up, trying to eat and thinking that it'll help it. It doesn't. You have to take rounds of corticosteroids to get everything under control, and if it gets bad enough, you end up in the hospital and you're having to take steroids through an IV to get everything uninflamed and back in check, and it's really not good. And if you can't get that under control, like I said, that's when surgery kind of plays a part. So you take up the step-up approach, and I have went through every medicine. I went through the lowest medication, it didn't work, so my symptoms just kept getting worse and worse and worse, and I kept getting scopes, and it was getting worse and worse. It was taking over more of my intestine, and I got to a point where I was at a point my senior year where it was just so bad that I was thinking I was gonna have to get surgery. You know, I don't know about anyone else, if I have to get surgery, you know, I have decided personally myself that I'm going to get everything removed. I want to be disease free, because with ulcerative colitis as opposed to Crohn's, you can remove the whole entire disease and technically disease free with ulcerative colitis, because you can remove all the large intestine and the rectum, just have your small intestine coming out of your stomach going into a bag, and essentially that removes all the disease and you're essentially disease free, as opposed to Crohn's, where even if you do that, it can still attack anywhere else in your digestive tract that hasn't been removed. But basically, like I said, I went through every medication. I had to take a bunch of different ones. I had to sit like 2-3 hours getting an infusion, which I did not enjoy at all. That medication didn't work, but now the medication that I'm on is called Simponi. Essentially, this medication is actually the first medication I've taken that is meant for moderate to severe ulcerative colitis. Every medicine I've ever taken has been for Crohn's. I know they're pretty much eerily similar, but like this medication I feel has worked more for me because it really targets the large intestine. It's actually meant for ulcerative colitis, and it's meant for mild or moderate to severe, which is a big thing for me because I was probably on that severe track, and a lot of the medications I took that were meant just for Crohn's were always mild to moderate, and I knew I was kind of in the moderate to severe range, so I needed a much stronger medication. You know, the story is that I'm doing great now. Needless to say, I am better remission for a while now. You know, I have my hiccups. I don't know if anyone else who has this disease or Crohn's or anything experiences this when they're in remission, but I kind of have relapses. Like it'll pick up again and I can start to feel it, but then I notice that it's either a diet thing that made it get worse, or maybe stress. Like I know when I'm moving is a big thing that stresses me out so much, and I know it can flare me up a little bit, or you know, like work, if I'm not, you know, something's going on at work, or anything of that matter, anything stress wise I think is what does it, or unless if I eat something that I tested the waters on just because I'm not too sure. I really have my diet down though now. Another thing, my diet that I do, I have a nutritionist, and the diet that I'm on essentially is called a low fiber diet. That's what my nutritionist said would work really well for me with ulcerative colitis, because you don't want everything to move, and what does fiber do? It makes everything move. So you do a low fiber diet where I'm just eating no whole grains, no seeds, nothing with high amounts of fiber. I have to have my veggies steamed, cooked, go mush, essentially to get off all the insoluble fiber on the skins that you have to cook off in order to eat those. I'm not allowed to have skin, so I have to peel off, like, you know, apples and etc. like that. I eat a lot of like white grain, you know, like bread. I have sandwiches, you know, and I mainly stick to meats. I'm not allowed to have pork. That's a part of the low fiber diet. You're supposed to just stick to chicken, you know, poultry, beef, white grains, rice, and stuff low in fiber. And that's really what I have found it really does help. It does help me because when you eat more, like every hour, as opposed to eating three meals a day, it really helps to slow things down too, because your body is just constantly digesting and it actually slows down the digestion process. So I've found that really helps me. You know, I'm gonna probably wrap up this video now. I just really wanted to raise, you know, awareness and let everyone know what I go through in a little bit of my daily life. My daily life, I've had to adjust in terms of making sure, you know, I always have to know where a bathroom is. Unfortunately, even when I'm doing good, I always have to, which really sucks, but you know, I've grown accustomed to it, and people don't realize that we can't help it, and we're not any different. I don't let it affect my work. If anything, you know, I work 10 times harder. Whether or not I can't miss a meeting or I'm late to work, I always make sure to let my managers know. They know when I'm not doing good. I feel like, at least for me, I can't speak for everyone else with this disease, but I like everyone to just be courteous of the fact that, you know, we can't help it. If we have to use the restroom, we have to use the restroom, so be it. And to just be courteous of the fact and understanding of the fact. I love it when people ask me about my disease, and I love it when people ask me, like, if I'm doing good, how am I feeling? And just like, what is it? You know, what is ulcerative colitis? What is it? How does it affect you? What does it do to your body? What are the symptoms? I love to answer those questions, and I will answer those questions for you guys. I really just wanted to do a video on this. I know this is not our main channel content. This is not the funny content or, you know, the challenge videos that we like to do, but I like to just remain positive about it, and that's how I handle this. You know, I remain positive every day, and I don't let anything get in my way or affect me or stop me because of this disease. And it just amazes me at how really no one knows anything about this disease. And I've just, it's sad that a lot of the troubles I've come through with this disease hasn't been the fact that, you know, my medications weren't working for years and it was getting worse and I had to deal with the pain and struggle every day. It was the fact that people just didn't treat me right. They thought of me, you know, as someone who just used an excuse to go to the bathroom or would go just to get out of work, school, anything. It even bothered my parents a little bit in the beginning until they were more understanding of it, because it is really something that's kind of strange to some people who don't have it and don't understand what we're going through. All right, enough talking. I just wanted to make this video to let all of you know a little more, like I said, about me and my disease. So if you guys have any questions, comments, anything, feel free to leave them in the link below or send us a message, and I will be sure to get back to you guys on that. I just want to be open with everyone on this channel, and I really want to raise awareness, and I feel YouTube is a good way to do that and a good way to speak about this disease openly. I've seen other people's channels and talking about this disease, and I absolutely love it. I think YouTube is a good platform to help get our voices heard and for people to understand a little more about this. You know, if I didn't cover something, you guys got, like I said, any more questions, be sure to comment below. If you like this video, please be sure to like it, and like I said, comment and subscribe. We would greatly appreciate it. We will see you guys in our next video.